Inyong napakinggan ang programang Pag-adalan Titangatang, hatid sa inyo ng DepEd Nueva Vizcaya on air. Antabayanan ang mga susunod pang aralin sa DWNS 96.5 UFM. Dito sa DepEd Nueva Vizcaya, handa na kami para sa new normal.
Good day everyone! Once again, my name is Leslie Nazaro Castro, your teacher in Contemporary Philippine Arts from the region. But before we begin, please observe safety protocol. Learners, what are you waiting for? Please get your module in Philippine Contemporary Arts, Quarter 1, Module 1 and 2, Contemporary Arts Forms, and their practices from the various regions. So today guys, we are going to discuss the various arts forms found in the Philippines. You can see this one on your module, page 1. What's in? In the previous lesson, we defined contemporary arts as the art of today, produced by artists who are living in the 21st century. There are various arts forms in the Philippines. The 7 major forms are visual arts, literature, music, theater, film, dance, and architecture. What I need to know? At the end of this lesson, the learners should be able to first, to identify the various arts forms in the Philippines. Second, to discuss the various arts forms in the Philippines. In the wordy challenge, you were able to answer this. First, various arts found. Very good. Arts form, found arts, Philippine arts form, and arts in the Philippines. Now guys, we are going to focus on visual arts. In your module, you can see 3 examples there. The first one is Spolarium painted by Juan Luna. The second one is Sculpture 9 Muses by Napoleon Avewa 1976. And the last one, we have the sketch Portrait of the Professor and Poinsettia Girls. If we are talking about visual arts, we have the 2D and the 3D dimension. Whereas, 2D is something like this, or like this, or like this. And if you're talking about 3D dimension, sabi nga sa Tagalog ay parang totoo. Yes, 3D is related to mathematics, specifically geometry. Why do I say so? 3D shapes are shaped with 3 dimensions such as width, height, and depth. 3D shapes are multidimensional and can be physically held. In page 3 of this module, you can see there the music instruments of Filipinos use. Maybe some of you are not familiar with this instrument. Guys, we are Filipino. So we need to promote this kind of instrument. So I will go into discuss the 8 instrument of the Filipinos use. 1. The flat gongs, commonly known as gansa and played by the groups in the Caldereta region, and bos gong, played among the Islam and animalist group in the southern Philippines. Number 2, sulibaw. Sulibaw is hollow wooden igorot drag top with pig skin or lizard skin, and this is played by striking the drum head using the palm of the hand. Number 3, we have tungatong. Tungatong is a bamboo percussion instrument used by the people of Kalinga to communicate with the spirit during blessing. It is made of bamboo, cut with various length. When you hit against the soft earth, a certain drum reverberates through the instrument. Open mouth. When an entire of tungatong or entire set of tungatong is played in interloping rhythms, the prolonged with the tribals chatting, it could put the audience and dancer in a trance. Tungatong sound like this. Something like that. 4. We have diudiu asis. Diudiu asis have 5 or more different size of slender bamboo that tied together. Diudiu asis sounds like this. Five, we have the sagipoy. If you're going to identify this one, is almost the same with diudiu asis, but the difference have the longer the pipe, the longer the pitch it produce. Number 6, we have bungkaka, bamboo buzzer. This made produce by vibrating. For number 7, we have kulintang. Refers to the crock gong rhyme instrument played in the southern islands of the Philippines, along with its varied accompanying ensembles. Last but not the least, rondolya. Rondolya is performed on ensemble comprising mandolin instrument of various sizes called the bandolya, composed of Liberian tradition. It has 14 strings. Imagine, it's amazing. Songs played by Filipinos, or we call it OPM. OPM means Original Filipino Music. Originally refers only to the Filipino or Philippine pop songs, particularly ballad, harana, and kundiman. In the 1920s, harana and kundiman became more mainstream musical style. Take note, guys, that music and literature are related. I'll give you an example. In literature, you do poem and then you can cater that through the use of music. Example, if you wanna be somebody, if you wanna go somewhere, you better wake up and pay attention. If you're going to put music on that, something like this. If you wanna be somebody, if you wanna go somewhere, you better wake up and pay attention. Something like that. Once more. In your module, in page 4, you can see there, Lesson 2, Activity 2. Number 1, it is the form of arts that refers to the staging and execution of production like drama, opera, and festival. A. Dance. B. Architecture. C. Theater. And D. Sculpture. If your answer is letter C, theater, your answer is correct. Number 2 refers to the rock gong rhyme instrument played in the southern islands of the Philippines, along with its varied accompanying ensemble. A. Kulintang. B. Rondolya. C. Bungkaka. And D. Tungatong. If your answer is A, kulintang, you're correct. Number 3, identify the 7 major arts forms in the Philippines. The answers are visual arts, literature, music, theater, films, dance, and architecture. Is OPM considered a contemporary arts? A. Yes. B. No. If your answer is yes, very good, you're correct. Number 5, Metropolitan is what contemporary arts forms in the Philippines? A. Painting, B. Architecture, C. Dance, or D. Theater. If your answer is B. Architecture, very good, you are correct. What I have learned? We have 4 things to mention. First, after the contemporary arts forms in the Philippines has been discussed, there are 7 major arts forms found, identified, and commonly used by Filipinos. Number 2, original Filipino music is another term for Filipino pop music. Number 3, describing our own Filipino instrument played especially in Cordillera region and southernmost region in Mindanao serve as our own identity of enriching our culture and tradition. Number 4, arts form usually appeals to the sense of seeing and hearing. Since I'm done with my part, it's your turn to shine. What I can do? Consider yourself as contemporary artist in the 21st century. In the 7 major forms of contemporary arts, select one and explain your work. Since today is pandemic, can I do arts? Of course you can. Example guys, if you have recorder, you can do music through the instrument. And of course guys, if you want to draw, you can use this one. Bunch of pencil colors and pencil. If you want to paint, you can do like this, and of course brush to paint. Since Tuao have a lot of raw materials, you can use coconut leaves to do waving and bamboo to make like this. So arts is everywhere. You can do singing, you can do dancing. So it's up to you to choose whatever you want. To give you the summary guys, the Philippine contemporary arts is a part of culture. As a reader, a viewer, you can gain a deeper knowledge about what contemporary Filipino artists do or did, and why and how they do or have done it. In doing so, you get to develop appreciation and gratitude for their artistic endeavor. Today, most Filipino contemporary artists still deal with current concerns that affect our country. They provide ways to allow the audience to participate in the experience. They acknowledge their Filipino roots by using natives and indigenous materials in their artwork, which show a growing sense of pride in being Filipino. In your module guys, on page 6, you can see their assessment post-test. True or false questions. Number 1, artists are self-taught and did not have any formal education. Originality is not issue in contemporary arts. True or false? If your answer is false, very good, you're correct. Number 2, it is not restricted to individual experience, but it is the reflective of the world we live in. Event in the world having an effect to the Philippines. True or false? If you answered true, excellent. That's correct. Multiple choice. Select the letter of the best answer from among the given choices. Number 3. One of the most internationally renowned pieces of modern Filipino art. It now hangs in the main gallery of National Museum of the Philippines and is the first painting to greet museum's visitors. A. Malarium. B. Selfie pose of San Jeronimo. C. Spolarium painting by Juan Luna. And D. All of the above. If you answer C, Spolarium painting by Juan Luna, very good, you're correct. Number 4, a human pursuit to imitate life and the world into something pleasing and beautiful. A. Contemporary arts. B. Art. C. Public speaking. And D. Digital arts. If you answer A. Contemporary arts, very good. You're correct. That's all, guys. See you next meeting.
Inyong napakinggan ang programang Pagadalan Titangatang, hatid sa inyo ng DepEd Nueva Vizcaya on air. Antabayanan ang mga susunod pang aralin sa DWNS 96.5 UFM. Dito sa DepEd Nueva Vizcaya, handa na kami para